the higher the pH, 7.2 or above, when we are talking about the saturation of hemoglobin with oxygen is high, and lower the blood pH. So in the acidic condition, when we are talking about the saturation of oxygen with hemoglobin is low. Other factor which is depending on the saturation is the amount of DPGs. So this also will be controlling the saturation of hemoglobin and oxygen. Now, when we talk about the control of respiration, both neural as well as chemical control is involved in the control of respiratory process. So, as we all know, in the medulla oblongata region, there is a region what we usually call it as the respiratory center. And this respiratory center is subdivided into three regions: the medullary rhythmicity area, the pneumotaxic area, and the apneustic area. Now, when we talk about the individual regions, the medullary rhythmicity area, it controls the basic rhythm of respiration. So that means in the normal respiration or eupnea, inspiration lasts for 2 seconds and expiration lasts for 3 seconds. So 24 plus 36, 60 seconds. So that is how we calculated 12 is the normal number of inspiration and expiration, or the rate of respiration per minute, which is controlled by the rhythmic control of the medullary rhythmicity area. Second area, what we usually call it as the pneumotaxic area, which is there in the upper pons. This transmits inhibitory impulses to inspiratory area so that it is turned off before the lungs becomes filled with too much of air. So this is a control area so that only the amount required or only the amount of air which the lungs can carry, or only the amount of air for the total lung capacity, will be allowed to be inspired into the body by the help of pneumotaxic area. The third region, the apneustic area, which is situated in the lower pons, sends the stimulatory impulses to the inspiratory area and it prolongs the inspiration. So in the case of required or more amount of oxygen is required, or if any breathing problem comes, so at that time this apneustic area will be helping in the deep breathing of the or do the process of deep breathing, and the lungs will be able to inspire more amount of air. Now, in addition to this neural control, when we talk about their chemical control or the chemical nature of the control of respiratory process, there are some kind of chemoreceptors which are associated with the chemical sensing of the partial pressure of oxygen and carbon dioxide, or in other words, the amount of acidic condition, and will be giving the message. So that is why when we are talking about hypercapnic situation or the hyperventilation process, the deep breathing or the depth of breathing can be increased or decreased depending on the amount of the substances which is present in the blood. Now, to detect the peripheral, or when we talk about the peripheral chemoreceptors, we can detect the amount of protons or the acidic level of the blood, the amount of carbon dioxide, and the amount of oxygen in the blood by two bodies, what we call it as the carotid bodies, which are present in the carotids, and the aortic bodies, which are in the wall of the arch of the aorta. So all these things together control the process of respiration, and the normal respiratory process will be associated with the metabolic rate of the individuals, and depending on the amount of protons and CO2 present in the blood. Therefore, we stop the process of physiology of respiration here, and I would like to thank all the members of GSBTM as well as all the members of BISAC who took patience in recording this lecture. And I thank you all once again. Thank you very much.
Vande Gujarat.